I'd like to give my first impression of a new book that I recently acquired called A Book by Book Guide, Old Testament Use of the Old Testament. And I'm not going to try to pronounce the author. And I thought a pretty good way to introduce this resource would be to compare and contrast it with another resource that I also have of, a commentary on the New Testament use of the Old Testament by G.K. Beale and D.A. Carson. So first we'll look at the Old Testament use of the Old Testament. This commentary has resources in it where well, let's just look at the book of Jonah here. This commentary will discuss how the book of Jonah uses other, or any Old Testament text, that uses other Old Testament texts within the Old Testament. I've known of several of these, and I was intrigued that this book even exists. I know that the book of Jeremiah references the book of Micah in one place, and it's very straightforward, and they even name Micah in that case. And so I thought, well, somebody actually wrote, I saw this and realized somebody actually wrote an entire commentary on the Old Testament use of the Old Testament. And so a good introduction to how this book works would be to look at how the book of Jonah is discussed in this book. So in this book, we have uses of the book, uses of other scriptures in the book of Jonah. So there's just two references here where the book of Jonah references other passages that are in the Old Testament. These two Exodus passages. But this index on the first page also tells us that other books reference the book of Jonah. And then finally, if the Old Testament book is referenced in the New Testament, there's this index on the first page of each book also tells us where in the New Testament this particular book is cited. So here we have two references where Jonah referenced other places in the Old Testament. One reference from the book of Joel that I did not notice before, but I turned and looked, and it's an obvious, at least an intertextual reference. So maybe they're both referencing the same language that was popular at the time, or one is referencing the other. They're kind of possibly close to authorship date, although Jonah might very well be a much later book than the book of Joel. And then here's this reference in the New Testament. Now, when we go through and look at the actual discussion of how Jonah uses scripture, what we'll see is a discussion of this top part, use of scripture in Jonah. So it talks about hermeneutical uses, how Jonah used these two Exodus passages. Also, other phrases, he calls them stock phrases. It's language that occurs in other places. It's intertextual, like here, dry land. Well, Jonah mentions dry land. Well, the word dry land appears in other places. Maybe that's useful, maybe it's not. Sort of stock phrases, but they're not necessarily referencing each other. They are they're using language, kind of like a hymn we'll always talk about. The modern hymns a lot of times like to talk about Jesus being the Lamb of God. They're honestly pulling stock phrases. It's such a popular phrase in modern hymns that they use it a lot. So there's a real simple introduction to how this book works. So if I want to find out about this Joel reference, I'll have to go over to the reference in Joel and read about what this author has to say. And it says, see attribute formula network. So another, if you look at it, what it did is an algorithm pulled it up because of a lot of similar words appear in both places. And if you go look at it, it's unmistakable. They're using the same language. But you won't find the discussion of how Joel uses it in this chapter. You have to go over to the Joel chapter to read how Joel references Jonah. And how Matthew uses Jonah is not going to be discussed in this book at all. You'll have to go maybe look at G.K. Beale's and D.A. Carson's book to find out about that. But it is there, and if we're studying the book of Jonah, there's a reference, an alert, that we might also want to go look at this passage in the New Testament. And maybe if we're teaching a class, we'd want to point that out. Hey, look at this. This reference, this passage in Jonah is referenced in the New Testament. And you can give sort of a discussion, a little bit of a discussion about how the New Testament used the book of Jonah in its context. Now, in a more complicated example, the book of Isaiah. We know the book of Isaiah is referenced a lot in the New Testament. And actually, what made me pull the trigger to buy this book was the fact that a particular passage in Isaiah is referenced quite a few times in the New Testament. Actually, several passages in Isaiah are repeatedly referenced. But the one that interested me was about, at the time, was about how Jesus had said, he had quoted Isaiah, hearing they don't hear, seeing they don't see. In one passage, it's a reference to why Jesus teaches in parables. And he quotes that verse. And the verse is also brought up in other contexts. So here we have all the passages where this author believes Isaiah referenced other books in the Old Testament. Here we have places where other books in the Old Testament referenced Isaiah. And then we have this very useful list of New Testament passages that reference the book of Isaiah. And the one that most interested me was chapter 6, 9 and 10. And look at all these New Testament references, which won't be discussed in this this resource here, but it alerts us that this passage is used. All these passages are referenced in the New Testament, and so we can go look at those as we're reading through Isaiah. We have this alert that we can go also notice. You know, when we get to this verse here, hey, I remember this being, or maybe I don't remember. But here's this list that says, hey, this reference, this particular passage or citation is cited by New Testament writers, and here they all are. Maybe I'd want to go look them all up and see how they used them. And then there's the discussion of how Isaiah uses other references in the Old Testament. There's no discussion in here about how the other places reference Isaiah. But we have this list. So we can go in this work and read about it in these places. And we can go to a different resource, like the commentary on the New Testament use of the Old Testament, and read about how the New Testament authors cite Isaiah. As you can see, there's quite a few references from chapter 53. That was a very common chapter to reference in the New Testament. Now let's compare that to what we might see in the New Testament commentary on the usage of the Old Testament. And I did make a deal about Isaiah chapter 6, 9 and 10, and so I would like to highlight that one. Here's one of the references. Mark chapter 4, verse 12. Handy right there at the top. And here it is. New Testament context of this passage here. And he tells us early on, this is a reference back to Isaiah 6, 9, and 10. And so, what's the context here? And he explains it. The author does. The commentator does. And then he explains how Isaiah used this verbiage. And what did Isaiah mean by it? And then he talks about how Mark used this passage. And what did Mark mean by using this passage? And then the next place in Mark where the Old Testament is referenced is in chapter 4, verse 32. So that's kind of useful. If you're studying Mark, we're alerted that Mark is quoting out of Isaiah here. And so we can go and read about that. We can use this as one of our resources for studying Mark. One of the things that I don't really care about this resource is there's not a very good index that tells me how to use this resource, the use of the Old Testament by the New Testament. How would I use this resource if I'm studying the Old Testament? So here I am studying Isaiah, and I didn't have this other reference that I just showed you. How would I know if I'm studying that, or how would I be alerted to the fact that this particular passage is cited in the New Testament? And I would not. I would not know if I didn't have another resource like the one I just showed you. The index in this commentary, there's an index way in the back of scripture citations, Old Testament citations that are referenced in this commentary. I'd like to like you to notice that Isaiah is in really small print here, because I'd like to point out that Isaiah 6, 9, and 10 is discussed in this particular commentary. But look how it's cited. There's a very small font for the book of Isaiah. So if I'm flipping through trying to find Isaiah, I might have trouble finding it. It ought to be listed up here in the headers that this is that the references to the book of Isaiah are on this page, but it's only in a very small font. And if I go to the next page, the word Isaiah doesn't appear anywhere. So if I open up to this, I'd ask myself, well, what are all these references? It's just a chapter and verse and a page number. So here, I'm highlighting just as an example, Isaiah chapter 6, 9, and 10. It doesn't have the New Testament citations. It has page numbers. And in fact, the page number that we were on when I was showing you this is page number 150. And so there it is, page 150. So I don't think this is a very good index. Perhaps this resource, if I want to use it as a resource for Old Testament study, I might be better off getting an electronic copy of it, like through Logos or Olive Tree. I'm hoping, I haven't paid for it yet, because after all, I have the real world version. So it's difficult for me to drop extra money on a soft copy, just so I could maybe be studying through, say, the book of Isaiah and get to these verses in chapter 6 and be alerted that, hey, Beale and Carson's commentary on the Old Testament, New Testament use of the Old Testament discusses this in these places, and I can just click on it, hopefully, and go to it. I don't know how good that is. Now, look how thick this book is. It's a pretty thick book. And it does say that it's Beale and Carson, but they're editors. But this is the table of contents. And you can see that there are a lot of contributors. I look at them, and a lot of them I see they're kind of reformist type, Calvinist types. Here's a bunch by Carson. Here's a one by Beale. Here's another one by Beale. But there's also a lot of other contributors. And over here, it has a list of contributors. There's 15 of them. So I would think, wow, how do you put together a commentary like this? Well, you get guest, you get some people to help you write the thing. One of the things that amazes me about this other one, Old Testament use of the Old Testament, is that the whole thing's written by one guy. I think he had some computer software to help him on that, but there's no list. There's only one contributor, the author. And he explains that he used an algorithm that alerted him to other references by usage of by finding frequently used words in two different places. And perhaps those are linked in some way, and then he would study it and find out if they were or were not. And he wrote this reference. It's kind of a commentary, but he wrote that based on his findings from just his knowledge of the Old Testament, but also perhaps from a computer algorithm that alerted him to references where Old Testament places reference other places. So that it's quite a work. It's almost like, a person's life work comes together in a book this big. This is as thick as Carson and Beale's book. It's quite a thick resource. I'm eager to start using it in my own Old Testament study, and I do think it'll be a very useful resource.